There's a thousand miles between you and I. Oh, my, my, my. Just a thousand miles between me and paradise.
Just got a call that Martin is broke down in the middle of the night. We don't know what's wrong. We've got a few hours to figure this out, or we're gonna have to cancel the show in Texas.
So tonight, Peter was kind enough to let me use his Corvette because I have a very important date. And I really want to impress this gal, and so I thought I'd better dress nice and drive the Corvette, because she is 10 out of 10, let me tell you.
If you're down and it can't get worse, give me all the pain and hurt, promise.
Okay, we are in the Crystal Shops, and we are going to a brand new place for dinner. Apparently just opened. Do you remember what it's called? Toca Madero, I think. Really been like a hot spot lately, so we thought it'd be fun to try. I have no idea what kind of food it is. I think it might be Mexican, yeah, or Mexican fusion, Mexican. But yeah, it's gonna be a fun evening. What you got?
It's necklace. I think I need that for my half birthday.
Okay, we are off to dinner now. We just spent quite a bit of time at Tiffany's so that Christina could decide what engagement ring she wants someday.
We will build a home, and we'll watch all the flowers grow until our bones can hold.
Christina, what'd you think?
I thought it was epic.
Yeah, what'd you like about it?
Can I say that?
So we finished a great week of rehearsal in Montana. We got the truck issues resolved. The truck was sent on its way to go to Texas. We flew back to Las Vegas. Our crew flew to Texas. We were getting ready to fly to Texas when we got a call from our truck driver, Martin, that the truck had broken down in Sheridan, Wyoming. It was crazy, because we realized we only had a few hours to find someone to come out and look at it. It was really hard to get someone to come out and look at it. I know Juliana was on the phone trying to find a mechanic to come out and look at it.
I called every repair shop, every truck rental option, and everyone was just like, sorry, we can't help you. You know, so I'd be like, oh, well, do you know anyone that could help us? You can try this person, and no one was really picking up. We found one guy that was a possibility, but we didn't think that would work out, so then you called him.
So we prayed a lot, and finally we found an owner of a diesel mechanic shop that didn't have any mechanics available, but him being a mechanic himself was willing to come out and look at it as long as it didn't take more than 15 minutes. He came out, looked at it, ended up spending about 4 hours on the truck, which was a miracle in itself. We knew we only had about a 6-hour window to get the problem fixed, or we wouldn't make the show in Texas. Ended up being a oil sensor. The challenge is right now with the supply chain issues, it's almost impossible to get truck parts. We couldn't find an oil sensor anywhere within a several state area to get the part in time. He was kind enough to actually give us the oil sensor off his truck. So basically putting his truck out of service so that our truck could make it to the show in Texas. And that was such a blessing. And long story short, Martin made it in time to the first show, and we had a great show in Texas.
So I'm back on tour. Woo! Woo! Alright, guys.
I find it hard to keep my head on straight. I find it hard to make new friends nowadays. I find it hard to find some constant love. So I went and I come around and fell in love with these drugs. I find it hard to keep my head on straight. I find it hard to make new friends nowadays. I find it hard to find some constant love. So I went and I come around and fell in love with these drugs. Who's gonna pick me up when I'm down? No one. I'm just trying to find some pleasure in it, yeah, yeah. I could really change the weather in here, yeah, yeah.
I think the part that makes me most nervous is just like not even being on stage, but the responsibilities of when I'm not.
No, same.
Like, that's the part. Like, what if I just forget?
Tell me what I wanna hear. Okay, life's not fair, no. Is it just the way I live? I can't tell, no. I don't have a fuck to give. Time will tell, though. Chilling in the deep and I keep gambling with my life.
Worked all day for the signature on the wall. We were many times here and we couldn't find it. And Dad got in the car before we could find the wall again. But
we did the show for the first time in about 2.5 years, and we only had about a week of rehearsal, so it was intense. And I run the lights, sound, and video for the show, and it's about 150 cues in 90 minutes. But as soon as the show started, everything kind of just came back to everybody.
I think that doing the show went so well. I feel so excited about it. I was so nervous, and I didn't know how it was gonna go, because the last time I did the show, I had just turned 16, and I'm 18, so it was almost like a totally new experience. But I felt really good about it, and it overall made me really excited to continue to perform and do the show in Vegas.
It felt really good to do the show for the first time after not doing it in 2.5 years. There was a few things that were a little rocky, but I don't think the audience knew. It went really well. And I'm really excited though that we still have 7 shows left on this mini tour. I think by the 7th show, it's gonna be perfect. And I can't wait to bring our show to Vegas.
So I've been performing since I was 14 years old, and I guess I never really thought about the fact of how much that kind of played into my identity. So it felt so good to be back on stage again last week in Texas, and it just was an amazing feeling. I love performing with my family. I love the opportunity to bring people a sense of joy and wonder, and it felt like I was home again.
One of our favorite things about living in Vegas now is the shopping. Yeah.
If you're right here in front of me, if that's not you knocking at my door, I don't want nobody's body on me. Want it to be yours, yeah. If it's not you looking straight into my eyes, I swear that I'm not breathing anymore. Don't you know I'm falling, falling, with my hands here by my side. Can't you hear me calling, calling, if I can't help you here tonight? Won't you help me lose my, lose my, lose my mind? Lose my, lose my, lose my mind. Lose my, lose my, lose my mind. If I can't help you here tonight.
Yes, Jay. Yeah, I'm here on site. There's a big hole. We have a big problem. There's a hole where the tent's supposed to be. Are you aware of that? It's a big problem. What are we gonna do?